Hi, it's Jordan-teen-1, and this is part 2 of how to make my Loomigurumi Squirt the Turtle. So if you haven't done part 1 yet, I will add the link. You need to do that first. And in part 1, I showed you how to make the head and the flippers. And then in part 2, you're going to learn how to make the shell, the top, and the bottom. And then you'll learn how to put all of the pieces together. So I had a ton of fun designing him. I love the way he turned out, and I hope that everybody else does too. As far as the band counts, I just wanted to give you a quick reminder. This is the total for the entire turtle. I used 50 white, 580 green, 273 brown, 57 black, 60 red, 26 yellow, and 211 tan. The shell is going to start with a magic ring of 5, so I have 6 yellow bands. So I am tripling my first. Again, if you wanted to use a twist tie or the loomiloom, you could do that. And then I'm just going to pull through all 5 one at a time. There's 2, three, four, and 5. Add my clip, and then just spread these out around the circle. In row 2, we're switching to red, and you're doing an increase in every stitch. So we are going to have to do a slip stitch since we are changing colors. So you're just pulling through everything on your hook. Get the other end back on. You should just have 2 red and 1 through the other. Then back through the same stitch a second time since we're doing that increase. And then it's an increase in every stitch. So this is what is going to be like the flower pattern. And it has the yellow center and then the red for the petals. If you notice, the shell has that flower pattern on it. And in my other one, I used orange, like a yellow orange, that neon orange for the middle. So either one would work nicely. And here's my last one. In row 3, you're going to need 20 brown bands, and we're doing a single followed by an increase. But the increase every time is going to be 3 bands instead of 2. So in my first stitch, I'm doing a single. Again, I need to do a slip stitch since I'm changing color. So just the 2 browns and 1 through the other. Then in the second stitch, I have my increase. But as I said, it's going to be a total of 3 bands. So that's 1, 2, and one more time. So that was 3 in the same stitch. Next one just gets a single. And then that increase of 3. So there's 1, 2, 3. And then that's just going to continue to repeat. So the reason that I did the 3 is because I really wanted it to flare out, and those are going to be basically like the corners. So this is going to make the shape of that pentagon.
have one more set here. And let me just take this out. Your last band is going to get the 3.
In row 4, you'll need 25 black, and it's starting with 2 singles and an increase. This time the increases are only going to be 2 bands, and then the pattern's going to be 3 singles and an increase, and you're going to end on 1 single. So we're starting with 2 singles, and I should have noted on the previous row probably, since we started with a slip stitch, you can see how the band sort of comes up and then goes over. So this first little part's not a true stitch, it's actually just made from doing the slip stitch. It was the same on the red, I just didn't really notice it. So just ignore that first little part, and we're going to do another slip stitch since we're changing color. So pull through everything, you'll have just the 2 blacks, one through the other. We have our second single. And then in the third stitch, we're doing an increase. And as I said, it's just with 2 bands. And then that's going to start our pattern of 3 singles followed by the increase. So there's 1, 2, 3, and then your increase. And you should notice that the increases are going to fall around the corners. So you can see how it's flat, flat, and then that should be like a little bit of a corner. So we're just going to keep repeating. So that was 3, so now I'm on to an increase. And it definitely will be pretty tight with the bands kind of scrunched together. Now these black bands that I'm using, I think I mentioned this in a previous tutorial, they seem to be cut super thick for some reason. I have my increase. I'm actually anxious to get these used up. And hopefully when I go buy new ones, they're not going to be so chunky. I have my 3 singles. I have an increase. Now this is going in the second to last stitch. And then I have 1 left here where my clip is. Let me just take this off. And then what you can do is just sort of go around and try and get it smoothed out, because I know the bands are packed pretty tightly. In row 5, we're doing 2 singles and an increase, and then the pattern is 4 singles and an increase, and you're ending on the 2 singles. So for every increase, it's going to be a black band first, and then a brown. So again, this first little part was a slip stitch, so ignore that. We're starting with a brown, so we're going to do a slip stitch. And we have just the 2 brown to start. We're going to do an increase, and the first one's going to be black. So we're doing a slip stitch. We're going to start to do a lot of slip stitches. And then back through that same stitch a second time with a brown, and again do that slip stitch. And now we're going to be doing 4 brown. So there's 1. 2,
3, 4, and then we're going to do our increase. And again, you should notice it should line up right along the corners. Again, we have a black, so slip stitch, back through the same stitch, brown, and slip stitch. Again, we have the 4 brown. So you'll definitely be getting familiar with slip stitches if you weren't already. And we have our last brown. And then we have our increase. So black with a slip stitch. And then brown with a slip stitch. Or brown. So doing slip stitches are pretty easy, I think. The hardest part is just realizing which bands you need to go into and which ones you need to ignore as you start to build this out. So I'm onto my slip stitch in black and then a brown one. That was our increase. And you should definitely notice the shape should be making that shape of a pentagon with the 5 sides. Here's our last increase. So black, slip stitch, brown, slip stitch. And then that should leave you with 2 stitches. And they are just brown singles. In row 6, we're going to be increasing our stitch count to 35 bands, and you can see we're going to start to add some red. So we're starting with 2 brown singles. Again, just be careful, this was a slip stitch on the previous row, so ignore the first little part. It's just a regular single since we're still staying with brown. Under the next one, 2nd brown. Now where we did the black, that was a slip stitch. So you can see it looks kind of funny. Looks like you have the one band poking up, the other one going over. Just remember you're always going to that second one, the one that is more horizontal. We're doing an increase, same as we did on the previous row. We're starting with black, it's a slip stitch. And then back through that same stitch a second time, we're doing the brown, that's a slip stitch. Next one, you can see this was a slip stitch, so go into the next one over. It's 1 single. Next one, we're switching to red, so slip stitch. I know there's like a million slip stitches. Next one over. It's a red, and then we have 2 brown, so we will be doing a slip stitch. Get that red off your hook, 2nd brown, and then when we hit the black, that was the slip stitch, ignore the first. So I'm going to remind you here at first, but I'm not going to keep going crazy pointing it out every single row. So you're doing a slip stitch with the black, back through the same black stitch, this time switching to a brown, so slip stitch. Now again, ignore the first. We have 1 brown, and then we're doing our 2 red. So do your slip stitch, 2nd red, slip stitch with the brown, 2nd brown, and your increases are always lining up, so go under the 2nd part of the black, do your slip stitch, back through for your increase, another slip stitch, ignore, one brown, slip stitch, we have our two red, two more brown, slip stitch, and under that second part of the black, this is our increase. So slip stitch, back through the same, another slip stitch, again, ignore. We have the one brown, whoops, and now two red, so just do that slip stitch with the first red, now the brown gets a slip stitch, we have our second brown, and we're almost done with this row, so ignore, do your slip stitch, and back through the same black with a brown, slip stitch, ignore the first little part, we have a brown, and then that should leave you with two stitches. And we're doing a slip stitch with a red, and finally we're ending on the red. So hopefully everybody got through that okay. And of course, as we continue to build, we're going to have a lot of slip stitches to deal with. But you can see it's starting to look really cool. In row 7, we're doing one single crochet into each stitch, and you can see we're starting to add some yellow. So we're starting with one brown, and this will be a slip stitch since we have red on the hook. And then under a brown stitch, we're switching to black. So do your slip stitch. And now we're going under black. Again, make sure it's the second part of that. We're doing two brown in a row, so slip stitch in the first, again ignore this first little part, we have our next brown, and then a brown stitch, we're switching to red, do your slip stitch, and then we're going under a red stitch. Now this was a slip stitch, so ignore the first. Switching to yellow, slip stitch, under the red with a red, another slip stitch, ignore the first little part, we have one brown, that's a slip stitch, under a brown, switching to black, slip stitch, now the black, again, make sure it's the second part, slip stitch with a brown, ignore the first, we have our second brown, and now we have the brown stitch with a red, stitch, ignore the first little part of the red, switching to yellow, that's a slip stitch, under a red with a red, so slip stitch, and now ignore the first, switching to brown. So that was a slip stitch. Now black, slip stitch, ignore the first little part of the black stitch, slip stitch to brown, ignore the first little part, it's our next brown. Now we have a brown stitch with a red, slip stitch, ignore, we have a red with a yellow, slip stitch, under the red for a red, slip stitch, ignore, under the brown, slip stitch. Now we have a black under the brown, slip stitch, ignore, a black stitch with a brown, slip stitch, ignore, next brown. Now we have a red under a brown, slip stitch, ignore, red with a yellow this time, slip stitch, now a red with a red, whoops, I pulled it a little bit too far, went all the way through. So that was a red under a red with a slip stitch, ignore. Here's our last set of the same pattern, so slip stitch with the brown, brown stitch with a black band, slip stitch, ignore, black stitch with a brown, slip stitch, ignore, brown with a brown, brown with a red, slip stitch, ignore. We have a yellow slip stitch, and then finally a red with a red, do your slip stitch. Sorry if that was extremely repetitive. Just want to make sure that you're getting the right ones under the right color and doing all of your slip stitches. So you should notice that it starts to curve inward a little bit here since we weren't doing any increases. In row 8, we're doing one single crochet into each stitch. We have this repeating pattern, and you can see we're doing two yellow for the centers of the flower. So I'm going to stop pointing out where the slip stitches are, and I'm going to stop saying to do a slip stitch. You just know every time you change color, because it's happening so frequently, I'd be saying it like every time. So we're starting on a brown, so you can just pay attention when I, which side I go in, but you know it's always going to be that left. And then whenever you're changing color, just do that slip stitch. Now I have a black stitch with a black band. And then I have a brown and now a brown stitch with a red. Red stitch with a yellow. Yellow stitch with a yellow. And then a red stitch with a red. And now brown with brown, black with black, brown with brown, and then I have the brown, but I'm adding the red band. And then a red stitch with a yellow. That's the only part that's not going to line up as far as the colors. And now these will. So I have yellow with yellow. Red with red. Brown under brown. Black under black. And brown under brown here. Now here comes the part that doesn't line up. We have red under brown. And then yellow under red. And then it starts to line up. I think this yellow is the only time we don't do a slip stitch in this row. So now we're going to line up again. And now we're under the brown stitch with a red. Red stitch with a yellow. And then we're back to matching. Here's where you don't do the slip stitch. And we have one more set of the pattern here. This is our fifth set. The next two don't line up, so it's the red under the brown, the yellow under the red, and then the last two will match. So no slip stitch in the yellow. And finally you're ending on the red. In row 9, we're starting with an increase. It's going to be brown and then black. And then the remaining part is going to be a repeating pattern. So I'm starting in the brown stitch, and I am doing an increase. So the reason I'm doing an increase is just to get the colors to line up. If I would have just followed this rest of this pattern, it would have started on a black, and then a red would have been next to a black. So I didn't want that to happen. So that's why I'm doing that increase there. So now same stitch, now I'm switching to black. And then the black stitch, I'm doing a brown. And then a brown stitch is a brown. Red is lining up with red. And then yellow is lining up with yellow. And then I have a red under a yellow. Red stitch with a brown. Black under brown. So most of this row is not going to line up with the color. Now I'm going to keep repeating that pattern. So I have a brown under a black. And then a brown under a brown. Now I have a red under a red. And a yellow under a yellow. And then here it's not going to match. So we have the red under a yellow. and then a brown under a red. Black under brown. Brown band under a black stitch. Now we have a brown under a brown. So no slip stitch there. Now we get the red under red. Yellow under yellow. Now red band with a yellow stitch. I'm kind of messing up my pattern here with my bands. So now we have the brown under a red. Black under a brown. Brown under a black. And now we have the next three to line up. So brown, red, yellow, and then red under a yellow. And brown under a red. So we have this pattern one more time. Let me just push these bands up out of the way. So we're starting under brown with black. Brown comes under the black stitch. Next three line up, so brown. Red. And yellow, and then finally the last two, we have red under yellow and then brown under red. Whew, hope we got through that okay. Definitely so many color changes. Sound like a broken record. In row 10, we're doing one single crochet in each, so you're going to need 36 bands. It's that repeating pattern, and there's going to be that one additional brown at the end. So I have a brown stitch with a brown band, and no slip stitch. And they are going to line up better this time, so black under black. And then two more brown. Now we have a red under red. And then a red under yellow. And then a brown under the red. So other than that little section, they're going to line up. Back to repeating the pattern again. So brown, black, two brown, and then a red. Now here's the ones that don't line up. We have a red under a yellow and a brown under a red. Now they will line up. We're going to repeat the pattern. So that's a brown, black, brown, brown, and red. And now we have a red under a yellow stitch and a brown under a red stitch. And now they are going to line up, so brown black oops, forgot my slip stitch there. Brown, brown, red, and then red under yellow, brown under red. And we're repeating this one more time. That's brown, black, brown, brown, red, red under yellow, brown under red. And then since we had added that 36th stitch, we have one final brown. Row 11 is going to be all brown. It's 36 bands and it's one single crochet into each stitch. So I'm just going to go ahead and let you do that row on your own. Just be careful of the slip stitches. In row 12, we're doing one single crochet into each stitch. It's all brown, and the only difference is we're going in just the outer loop. So I'll go ahead and start this row with you, but then I'll let you finish it on your own. So we usually go under both loops of a stitch, but for this row, we're going to go just through the outer loop, or the one that's farthest away from you. So you just want to push down through the middle of the two bands and then push out. So it's really very easy, and you'll definitely notice that it feels a lot looser since you're just going under that one loop. So you're just going to do that the whole way around until you get back to the start. Making the base is very straightforward, so I'm just going to let you do that on your own. You're going to start with a magic ring of 6, and then in row 2, you're going to do an increase in every stitch. Row 3, you're going to do a single followed by an increase. Row 4 is 2 singles followed by an increase. Row 5, 3 singles followed by an increase. Row 6, 4 singles followed by an increase. Row 7, 5 singles followed by an increase. And then in row 8, you're going to do just one single crochet in each stitch. The next thing I'll show you is how to attach the flippers and the head. We're going to be doing this with just the upper shell for now. And you need a total of 22 of your brown bands, or whatever your shell color is. I also have 5 stitch markers. And if you don't have stitch markers, you can use clips, but you definitely need something to hold the loose bands in place until we attach the bottom. So I'm going to start with the loose band on the top shell towards the back. And if I flip it over here, where the black is, that's what I want to be the center of the head. And if you look here, if you recall, we went in just the outer loops in the last row, so you should have this one loop that's the inner loop that we didn't go in, and that is where we're going to attach. So I'm going to start with the head. I'm going to face it away from me and upside down, and you can see here where the black is. I'm going to count like 1, 2, 3 stitches over, so I'm kind of in line with the red here, going in just that inner loop. And then as far as the head goes, you have your loose band, And I'll say I'm going to go 1, 2 stitches from that. There's a total of 12 stitches in the head, so we're going to be attaching 6 just across the top. So take my brown band, pull through everything back on my hook, one through the other. Remember, you're just going in that inner loop that we had skipped on the shell, and then through both loops of the head. So that's 2. Try and keep that stuffing out of your way. I know it's hard. So here's 3. It's number 5, and one more, and then I'm going to take my clip or stitch marker and just place it on this loop so that way it's going to stay together. Now you can look and see what you think as far as the placement. So I think that looks pretty good. And then you have to determine where you're going to attach the front flippers here. So I would say kind of in line with the black. I'm going to use that as a guide, sort of in the middle of that. So let me just see here. So I have 1, 2, 3. Maybe I'll go down to the 3rd or 4th one away. And then I'm going to take my fin here and I'm going to turn it upside down, same thing. And I'm going to line these stitches up. Now I'm going to be doing 4. I'm going to connect with 4 on this. So what did I decide here? I went 1, 2, 3. I'll go to the 3rd one. And then I'm just going to start on the right side here. I mean, it's not an exact science. Yours can differ just slightly. It depends on where you want it to be. Just make sure you're going through that inner loop only on the shell. So there's 2. Three, and then one more. I feel like I went through something I wasn't supposed to. There we go. And again, use your clip or stitch marker and attach. And then you can always keep flipping it over and see what you think. Now, as far as the back fin here, I want that to be, let's see, maybe again use this black sort of as a guide. So if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe about 5 over, I'll go under that loop, flip this upside down. So I think I'll go to the stitch right before the loose band. So here's 1, 2, 3, and 4. So you are going to be left over with some stitches that you didn't go through on the legs here. Even when we get the other side attached, we're not going to wind up going through every stitch, but we're going to go through most of them. And now I'm going to skip just 2 spaces here. So this is attached through there. So 1, 2, going to start with the other back leg. And I should point out, even though I don't think I mentioned this, but I already have the button attached, but I have the part where we did the increases, the slanty part, I have that facing to the outside. So again, I want this upside down. I do have a loose band on the shell that I'm going to have to attach shortly. So again, find the corner here. So I'm going to do a total of 4 on this leg. So there's 1. And let me see where this loose band is. I think I'll attach it, not this one. So this is 3. And I actually have this loose band as well. So this is going to be the most difficult. I'm going to go through, going to go through the shell. This is also an awkward spot because it's where the shell had ended. So the rows, sort of the outer row, the loop that we're going through here is more outside, and now we're kind of jumping in a little bit. So I hope this isn't going to really totally throw you off, but I'm going through the inner loop of the shell. I have this loose band from my shell. I'm going to attach that. I have the loop for the leg, and then also the loose loop for the leg. I'm going to attach that. So I know that's a lot of stuff happening in that one stitch. And just do your best. If you wind up attaching it on a different stitch, or you feel like you just want to make a slip knot to tie it off, you can certainly do that. So hopefully, let's see, we got all of our loose bands tied in. Looks pretty good. And now I'm going to use my stitch marker here to attach. And then I'm going to go to the 5th one. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4. Here's number 5. And again, we are going to have a loose band on the leg to deal with. So I'm starting here in the corner. Let me slide this down. There's 1. And I want to attach this on this next one. So go through the stitch of the leg, but now also grab that loose band. So that's number 2. And then here's 3. And 1 more. And finally, the stitch marker. So, give yourself a pat on the back if you made it through that. You can see what you think as far as the placement goes. You can always do some adjusting if you need to. You should see how this upper row is going to curl up a little bit. That last row we did in just the outer loop. And it should be looking like a turtle. The final thing I have to do is take the bottom shell and attach it to the top shell. So I have 46 bands here, and I may need a few more or less. This is my estimate here. And what I'm going to do is to take this where the loose band is, and I'm going to put it in between the two legs, just because I don't want to have to deal with a lot of loose bands at once. And then I'm going to be going through the bottom shell. I'm going to be going through the inner loops here, the ones that we had skipped, for where the limbs are not attached, and then where the limbs are attached, what we're going to do is work our way around the parts that we didn't go through. So let me just start right here, and you can see I have my loose band. We are going to have to work in every loose band at this point, and I'm going to go through a spot on the shell here, on the lower shell. I'm going to grab this loose band, and you can see that this is, we did already go through this inner loop to attach this, but on the edges we're going to go through those again, just because we don't want there to be any holes or gaps. So I'm going to pull through everything on my hook. You may have to do a little bit of maneuvering, and one through the other. So now next one over, and that inner loop. Now the bottom shell has a stitch count of 42, and I have estimated that we need 46. So there are four stitches then that we're going to have to go into the shell four different times. We'll have to go through the same stitch twice. So you can see where you think it would work out best, where it's kind of already close together. So now I'm going through the stitch, this loop that we had already attached. In the upper part, I'm going through that one. And then in the next one, let's see, we're going to start to have to pick up the head. So let me stretch this loop out. You can see we went through this, so I'm going through the next one up. Again, just make sure this loose band, it has a clip on it, so it should be okay, but you just want to make sure that doesn't pull through, since you're putting extra pressure on that. And now I'm going to grab the loose loop. So I went through the bottom shell, the loose loop, and I'm going to go through the next stitch over. So I'm just going to work my way around here, get through that loose band as well. So I do have a loose band here when we get to the end of the head. Just want to make sure I don't forget about any of those. And here's another one. Looks like I'm almost to the end. Let me just see here. Yeah, I did already go through this one. So let me go through here. Let me grab this loose band. And then I'm going to go through just that brown loop again. Again, we had already gone through that in the upper part. Really fighting with these here. And now just keep working our way around. Now we're almost at the other leg here. So it looks like I'm going to go through the green, the one right before the loose band. And then I'm going to go through the loose band. Take off my clip and go through the next stitch over. Another one through the green, and it looks like this one is attached. So let me go through this loose band that held the top together. I'm going to go through this same stitch that the top went through, just that one loop. And now let me go through, let's see, I'm going to go through this same stitch on the shell, on the bottom of the shell, just because I told you we need to go through that twice on a couple of these, on four actually. And then it's just a matter of doing one in each here. Grabbing that inner loop. Now this is the loop that attached the top. We're going to go through that one again. And then we have a loose band on the green leg, and that looks like it's right here in the corner. So I'm going to go through that, and the next stitch up. Next one over on each. Again, moving over. We have this loose band. Do that when we get over to the corner. So let me go through the next on each. And then I think I'll stay in the same stitch again on the bottom. Go through the next one over. This is the last one on the leg. And now in the next one, I'm going to pick up this loose brown band. And again, the same inner loop that attached the other end of the leg. I'm going to go through that. Hopefully everybody is getting through this part okay. Now the next one over on each. Keep going over. We have it halfway done here, more than halfway. So now I'm going to pick up the next leg. Let me get that stitch marker moved over. And the next one. And then let me go through the same one on the bottom, next one over on the leg, just to make up those stitches. One more. Next, I have this loose band. Get it on my hook. And then also the one that attached the end of the leg on the top. I feel like I lost it off my hook. And I'm going to do a few more, but pretty soon we're going to need to close that off. Now I do have my loose band on the bottom that's going to have to get attached. That's going to have to be next. And I think that's where I'm going to quit for now. So let me just get my stitch marker, and then we're going to add our stuffing before this gets too small. So I'm going to just add my stuffing. Should have a decent size hole left to put it all in. Again, you don't want to overstuff it, but you want it to be pretty firm. So work it into the corners. And if you feel like the neck needs any more support, this should be open. You can actually stick your finger in and add more stuffing to the neck. Just be careful you don't want to stretch out the stitches. I can see here it makes it a little bit more of a gap there. You could always add an additional band to make that tighter if you needed. Now I have 7 bands left, so let me just pick up where I left off. So any stuffing should be added by now. And where we had attached this last band from the bottom of the shell, that's going to count as our next stitch. So just try and avoid your stuffing. And just like we did when we went around the other 4 legs, we did go through the shell part twice in one of the stitches. So we're going to have to do that again. Let's see, I have 1, 2, 3 left, and I have 4. So I think I'm going to grab the part of the leg. And then go through the next one. And then I'm going to go through the same one on the bottom shell again. And that should leave 1 for the bottom and then 1 green. It's going to be our last one. So that did work out nicely with the 46 bands. You're going to actually need a 47th band just to tie this off. So let me just go through one of the brown here. Pull through everything. Make a nice and tight slip knot. And then I'm just going to reach up from the inside, just try not to get any of the stuffing, and pull that through. Now, if you look along your seams here, if you see anywhere that looks like there's a gap, that you don't like the way it looks, you can always add some additional bands, as I had said earlier. I think, personally, right here, I think that looks too much of a gap, so what I'm going to do is just grab a loop. Let me grab a loop of the lighter tan and reach up, grab a loop on the bottom, that brown, take another band, pull through, and make a nice and tight slip knot. So you can do that wherever you think is necessary, or maybe you won't need to do it at all, and I'll just tuck that on the inside. And then your squirt is complete.
I hope that everyone loves their new Squirt the Turtles as much as I do. You can always leave me comments on YouTube and Facebook. You can post pictures of your creations to my Facebook page, and please feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel. So that way you can get updated when I have new tutorials available. You can also find me on Pinterest and Instagram, so please feel free to post your pictures and comments there too. And don't forget to tag me if you do post any pictures on Instagram. Thanks for watching!